हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू गीक्स फॉर गीक्स। माय नेम इज नितिन कपलस। सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट टुडेस प्रॉब्लम। आवर प्रॉब्लम नेम इज लेफ्ट रोटेट मैट्रिक्स के टाइम। सो लेट्स रीड द क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट। आवर क्वेश्चन सेड वी आर गिवन एन इंटीजर के एंड मैट्रिक्स मैट, सो वी जस्ट हैव टू रोटेट आवर मैट्रिक्स के टाइम्स टुवर्ड्स द लेफ्ट डायरेक्शन, राइट। हियर वी आर गिवन द इनपुट फर्स्ट, वी आर द वैल्यू ऑफ के इज 1, एंड वी आर गिवन द एन क्रॉस एम मैट्रिक्स, एंड योर आउटपुट शुड लुक लाइक दिस, राइट। एंड second example, the matrix will be same, but our value of k is updated, which is 2. So we just have to rotate twice in the left direction. So our output is this, right? Now let's understand how we can solve this question. So before solving this question in the matrix form, I hope you do that question when we have the array, right? And we just have to rotate my array k times towards the left direction, right? Now let's first do that part. For example, your array will be this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So in this case, your value of k is 2, right? So what is your answer, right? After rotate twice in the left direction. In first step, so what's your answer will be this. All the values I am shifting towards the left, and that value which is at the starting point, it will go at the end of it. Now it should be this. Value is 2, right? So we have to rotate once more. All the values will be shifted towards the left side, and the first value will shift towards the last. Your output will be this 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, right? So this will be your answer, right? Similarly, we have to solve this question. While solving this question, what we are doing is we just reverse 3 steps, right? We are reversing my array in 3 steps. So the first step, if you remember, that is 0 to k minus 1 we are reversing, and in the second part we are reversing from k to n minus 1, and in the third part we are reversing from 0 to n minus 1, right? So these are the 3 steps which we have to follow, right, while rotate in the left direction. So let's do this dry run for my array, right? So in the first case, what I am doing is I reverse 0 to k minus 1. What is k? K is 2. So k is 2. So let me write here reverse from 0 to 1, right? And if I do the reversing part on this case, so your array will be this. And in this case, you have to reverse from k, which is 2 to 4, right? So 2 to 4 is this. If I reverse this, it should be look like this, right? At the end of it, what I am doing is I reverse from 0 to 4, right? If I reverse whole array, so your answer will be 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, right? So this is what we want, right? So these are the 3 steps which we are following in that array part. The same we have to follow in my matrix part, right? Now let's do in the matrix part how we can solve this. Okay, so let me erase this. Okay, so let's shift this up. Okay, so see here, if your value k is 2, right, now we have to shift twice to the left direction. So let's follow these steps, right? Now in this case, what we have to do is the first step is this, right? While reversing it, let me write the reversing code here. What we have to do is your value is 0 to 1. So let's suppose this 0 is your low and this is high. Now your low will be here and high will be here, right, pointing to this case. Now, so what we are doing in that case is I just make a while loop, and we have the two variables, which is high and low. Always your high will be greater than your low, right? That's the simple idea in the 1D array. Now we have the 2D array, right? Now what my task is, I just want to swap these two values. I just want to reverse these two values. Now my answer will be like this: 2, 4, 8, 2, 5, 8, and here we have to this, right? Now if I'm checking, hey, low is greater than low is less than high. Yes, it is. Now what I'm doing is I reverse whole my column part, right? Now in the column part, what I'm doing is I just run a loop until your number of columns you have, right? Now here we have n, right? So what is n? If I write here, what is n? N is matrix ka size, right? Now what is this value? If I just write, let's suppose this is your m. So what is M? M is particular size, right? Mat of zero dot size, right? Okay, so this gives you the M and this is your N. N just represent number of rows you have and M tell you number of columns you have, right? Now in this case, I just have to swap these values. So I is zero, right? My I is zero, let me write here. I is this and low is zero, right? Now what I'm doing is, here I'm do the swap part of mat of I and low with mat of I high, right? If you see clearly, what I'm doing is, this is my I part and this is my low part and this is my high part, right? Now I am doing mat of I low. What is I? 0. Low is 0. So 0, 0 is 1 and 0, 1 is this. So I am swapping these two values, right? Similarly, 4, 5 is swapping. Similarly, when I go into the for loop of it and I is increasing in the down part, right? What we are doing is, we just swap these two values, right? Now, if you see here, your swapping is done, right? After swapping is, what I am doing is, I just increment my low and decrement my high, right? Now this value will be here and this will be here. In this case, your while loop will finish, right? It will be break. Now if you see, 0, 1 is covered, right? Now my main task is to this part. Here your value of k is 2 and what is your m? It's also 2, right? Now 2, 2. Low is here, high is here. It's not running because it not satisfy your while condition because it's already sorted, right? It's already reversed. So what I'm doing is let me write in this case. Now this part is also finished. Now 0 to m minus 1 means we have to reverse this all, right? If I reverse this all, how it's look like? 3, 6, 9, 1, 4, 7, 2, 5, 8. If you do the dry run for this case, when your now in this case your low will be this and high will be this, right? So in this case I just do the swapping of these two. I just do the dry run for this case, right? While this is solved, so your answer will look like this. So that's my answer, right? You just have to apply these three conditions, right? Now let's do the coding part. Hope you understand the intuition, right? Now let's do the code. So in the coding part, the first is, I just want M value. Your M is your size, right? How many rows you have, how many columns you have, right? So in this case, what I'm doing is, I just reverse, calling a reverse function, where I'm passing mat and low value 0 to k minus 1 and reverse mat of k to m minus 1 and in the third part, mat of 0 to m minus 1. Right, so that's the simple idea. Okay, now let's do fill this case, right? Let's do the reverse function. Now in the reverse function, the first value is my matrix. Okay, the first is matrix and second is low and high, which are the two values, right? Two variables. Now in this case, what we have to do is, I just have to write the while loop. And this is the condition. Inside this, I need the value of number of rows you have. So n will be mat of 0 dot size. Okay. So inside this, what I'm doing is, I just swapping with this number of rows we have and swap of mat of I with your low, mat of I with your high, right? When this is over, so just do the low plus plus and high minus minus, right? So that's the simple intuition. Okay, after end of it, what we are doing is, I just return that particular matrix, right? I'm not changing any matrix, not using any extra matrix, right? So one condition you have to focus here, your value of k, if you see the constraint part, your value of k will be very large. It's not in the boundation part of your n or m, right? So what I'm doing is, we just have to write k will be modulo of m, right? It should be in that part, right? What's the size of my n, right? Now let's check it's working fine or not. Okay, yeah, the compilation is good. Let's submit and check. Okay, yeah, it's working fine. Hope you understand. So let's understand its time complexity. If you see here, what I'm doing is I just calling reverse function 3 times, means constant time. And in the reverse part, what you're doing is my low is pointing to somewhere and high is pointing to somewhere. Inside this, what I'm doing is I traverse my whole number of rows, right? So in the worst case, this function will run big of n into m, right? Your reverse part, reverse function, n into m. And we're calling this 3 times. So what's your time complexity? Time complexity will be big of n into m, right? And what's my space, extra space? Big of 1. I'm not using any extra space while following this question, right? I hope you understand the solution and intuition. Thank you so much.